Hey, what's happening, everybody? It's your old pal, Mr. Butter, coming back at you. And it's a holiday weekend. I picked up a pair of kicks today that I had EA for through Finish Line. It was weird because after I reserved a pair in store, then I also got an alert for EA for the ship to me option. I don't think there's a lot of hype to this pair. It might just be due to the fact that there's a lot of other kicks dropping. But I want to review these Green Bean 5s with y'all. If you're into kicks and you feel like hanging out, then hit that subscribe button. Let's look at these Green Bean 5s.
I always say that I'm a fan of having a box that goes along with the shoe, and here we get just that. I think this is even reflective on the base of the box, which is really cool, but we've got this nice bright green Jumpman or green bean colored Jumpman. It's kind of oversized and it's just a nice gray colored box, so it really does match the shoes pretty well. The tag reads Air Jordan 5 Retro. The colors are silver, green bean, and flint gray. The retail price for these was $200 US. And I used some status rewards for 10 bucks off. So I got a little bit off of them. And then here they are, the Jordan 5 Green Beans. This is, I believe, the second time that this colorway has released. And I never owned the first pair. I am a fan of fives. I'm actually wearing a pair of fives that I picked up from this year. And it's one of my favorite pickups this year. I'm wearing the Jade Horizons, and I know that a lot of people weren't feeling them or whatever. It looks like online, I think some sizes of these are sitting, and I know at my local Finish Line, they had a lot of sizes left that weren't claimed through the raffle. So I don't know if that's because fives just don't seem to have the pop that they once did. It doesn't seem like people really go crazy over fives anymore. And also, there is just so much stuff dropping right now. I swear it's been overcast all day, and then the second I start to do this, I start cooking. I'm a big fan of the Jade Horizon fives. I would like these a lot more if the whole upper wasn't this synthetic reflective material, and it does glow really nice. But if this was that same kind of nubuck or suede that had that cool finish on it like these Jade Horizons do, I would like these a whole lot more. And also, I feel like these look like moon boots or something, especially when you're looking down on them. I was looking at them compared to my Jade Horizons. And let me see if I can get a good shot. So I don't know if you're able to tell or not, but when I was looking at the green beans next to the Jade Horizons, this mug guard area comes straight up. It's like 90 degrees. So you don't see much of the mug guard like coming back on the shoe. Whereas with the Jade Horizons that I have on feet, you can see this mug guard kind of comes back at a slope. And it looks so much nicer whenever you get a nice angle. But unfortunately for these, the front of them just comes straight up. And it really makes it look like a moon boot or something. Like, it just gives it a, I don't even know how to explain it. It looks like something that, like, Billy Corgan from the Smashing Pumpkins would wear when he was in that like Zero kit, bullet with butterfly wings or something, or like just something that David Bowie would wear with a spacesuit or something. But anyhow, so when given a choice, I will always take a more natural type of material as opposed to 100% reflective. I like reflective and I like little accents of it, but to have a whole shoe in reflective, it's just not my cup of tea, you know. But I like the colors, I like this shade of gray, and I like the way that green bean really jumps off of there. It really is like a vibrant color of green. And I've always been a fan of the five silhouette. It's one of those shoes that I remember MJ playing in, and I mean, it's just hard to forget that kind of stuff whenever you're a kid. I don't feel like this is one that I have to keep in the collection though, especially because, like I said before, I'm rocking these Jade Horizon 5s and I really, really like them. So the 5 isn't something like the 1 or the 4 that I have a whole bunch of pairs of that I rock a whole bunch of different colorways of. It kind of reminds me of the Bel Air 5s, like not the second ones, but the first ones, that shade of gray. But I like the Bel Air 5s a whole lot more just because it wasn't this synthetic material on the whole upper. I'm not trying to knock anybody that does like them. I'm just giving you my opinion. And I don't know, for me, this just isn't something, realistically, this isn't something I would see myself wearing a whole bunch. But that being said, we'll start with this outsole. It's got some icy blue on it, and I like how you can see that green bean Jumpman there up under the forefoot. It's got that herringbone traction pattern under the forefoot and the heel. And then you can see this nice gray color where it spells out Jordan there at the midfoot. And you've also got that gray up here in the front. And then as you come to the midsole, you can see that icy blue translucent material wrapping up to the side a little bit. And that meets that bright green, the green bean color there for the shark teeth. And again, we just have a lot of that gray color. And the colors definitely go together really, really well. And too, a lot of people do really like reflective. So if you're really into reflective, I mean, I say go for this shoe. But it looks like inside of the air unit, it's white. And I like it whenever they give us a little bit of contrast in there. I think that's a cool touch. But then on the inside of the shoe, you can see another little painted hit of that green and that icy blue. The paint on these looks really, really neat. So they got that right. But then coming up from it, as noted before, it's just a super synthetic feeling material. And it looks like this gray color. When light hits it in the least bit, it really glows. You might even see on camera it glowing a little bit, but it's hard for me to tell if you all can see it. But depending on how the sun hits it while I'm out here, sometimes it is lighting up. But it looks like it's got all gray stitching to match on those panels. And then on the sidewalls, we've got that typical kind of rubber netting that we always get on fives. And that's in that icy blue material as well. And then on the heel, on the back of the shoe, we've got a bright green Jumpman stitched in there. And then going up the eye stays, the little plastic hits on the eyelets matches that painted color on the midsole. And I like the way that ties in together. But they gave us some flat gray laces. And just below that, on the base of the tongue, we have more of this netting like we have on the side. And then up at the top, we've got more of that gray reflective material with another bright green Jumpman stitched into there. And we've got this standard lace lock like we always get on fives. I typically take off that clear part and just rock the little inside of it, the button part. And on the back of the tongue, it says Air Jordan, and this is actually right side up that it says it. But let me know what you all think of these. I don't dislike them, but it's not a shoe that I would see myself wearing a whole bunch. My wife actually likes these more than the Jade Horizons. She thinks they're really, really cool. And I think it just comes down to preference. If you really like full reflective, then this is going to be an awesome shoe for you. But I just kind of like more natural looking materials. Anyway, hope y'all have a good one. I'm out.